This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so let's talk about some more thing in interface. We have discussed earlier in the interface, right? For example, I am creating an interface, inter one. Interface inter one. Correct. So this is an interface. In the interface, what I told, we have to create all the abstract method, right? Public, maybe void, say M1, right? We cannot create a body of a method. If we create a body of a method, we are getting an error message. That's what we are aware. In the interface, we cannot body of a method, we can create an abstract method. Now, the class, we can extend implements that interface, right? Implements inter one. Correct. Now, if I, as soon as I do it, I have to add all unimplemented methods. So I am adding the unimplemented methods M1. Correct. So here I can write M1 inside class. What I can do? I can create the object like this with the help of interface or with the help of class x equal to new test interface. Using x dot, I can call M1 method, correct? If I run, I am getting the output. If I add one more method, I have to re-implement all one more. I have to overwrite it again here, right? In that class. That's what we saw. Thing is, in Java 8, they came up with a concept that told, if you want, you can create a method inside interface. That is called method implementation inside interface. If you want, you can create a, implement a method inside interface also. But you have to declare it as default. Default void, say M2. Default void M2. Can you see? That is came up into Java 8. If you are using older version of Java, you cannot do it. You will get an error message. See, I don't have to re-implement it. I don't have to override it. Can you see? I have not overridden any method. Here, I am writing M2 inside inter 1. x.m2. See, I can access it. Got it. If I create the M2 method again here, M2 inside class. If I run it, see, it is calling M2 inside class, not from an interface. So if you rewrite the method, you are overriding, right? You are overriding the same method. That time, the first preference will always be the class, right? Object of the class, whatever you are creating, it will take the first preference. That's what we saw in inheritance also. So it will be called from here. This is a little bit in details concept. You may not require all these things, but in the interview, in case they ask, you can create a method in an interface also. Static void M3. You can create a static method also inside an interface. You can write M3 inside inter 1. X dot C. I am not able to access it here. X dot. Can you see? So how to access it? Access it. Dot inter. Interface name is inter. Inter one dot. Can you see M3 I can access? I can access it directly. Inter one dot M3. If you create a static method inside an interface, you can directly access it. You can create an interface. You can create a method inside an interface from Java 8 if you declare it as a default. Clear? I am creating one more interface. Let's talk about little bit in details. Guys, whoever done, you know, my practice and all, whoever followed my videos, I'm sure they are able to follow. Others, it will be difficult. If you're not following later, there will be a lot of stuff and you cannot follow it properly. Okay, so if you are not practicing it, no one can help you. As I told you, day one before itself, you join the course. You cannot learn overnight. There will be a lot of ifs and buts in your mind. If you follow it properly, so this is the last week we are continuing Java. Next week we'll be starting with web driver. In between, we'll talk about more Java. So if you have not done it, I want you guys to spend proper time this week, whole 5 days, and clarify all the concepts. And next week you can ask me before we start with the web driver. I am happy to clarify all of your doubt. I want you to learn the things. You are spending money, you are spending time here. So there should be some return. That's what I want. Okay. Anyway. So here also, if I declare again M2 method, what will happen? M2 inside inter 2. So if I call like this, inter 2 y y dot m2. So okay, I have to implement, right, inter 1 comma inter 2. But see the problem, m2 is there in inter 1 also, m2 is there in inter 2 also. Okay, inter 2. So in such case, if I write like this, m2 will be called from inter 1. Here m2 will be called from inter 2. Let me run. No, sorry. Okay, so that is the case. Sorry, I forgot to tell you. If there are two methods present in inter 1 and inter 2, if I write like this, I can create an object like this also, right? Z equal to new this. Now z dot m2. Now from where m2 will be called? Where it will be called from? It will be from where it will be called? Will it be called from inter 1 or inter 2? This you might say it will call from inter 2. This you might say it will call from inter 1. But what about this case? So multiple inheritance concept comes here, right? And you know, I told you first, a multiple inheritance is not supported in Java. So what they told, if you have re-implemented two methods in two different interface, and in a class, if you are implementing both the interface, it's mandatory for you. You have to rewrite the method. You have to override the method. It's mandatory. You cannot skip it. Otherwise, you will get an error message. Can you see? Now there is no error message. If I run it, it's calling from M2 inside class. Got it. So if same method, you are rewriting in two interface, and if a class implements both the interface, then multiple inheritance concept comes, right? Remember multiple inheritance, I told you. Here is one class, here is one class, here is one class. That is not allowed in Java. That's concept. So to overcome this situation, they told, no, we don't want to change our concept. So it's mandatory for the user to re-implement the same method inside the class. So you have to override this M2 method. Okay, if there are two method, two default method are there in two interfaces. Clear? So this is the thing which introduces in Java 8. That's what I wanted to explain you guys. Clear? Any doubt?